principle.
Hello everyone and welcome, I'm Walla Walla and tonight we're going to be playing Mass Effect 3. Now as usual I will be recording this live stream and it will be uploaded to my YouTube channel sometime after the stream has ended, so of course if you are watching this at a later time, be sure to like and subscribe if you do enjoy what you see. Now I've just mentioned the Diddlicks, I have a fan on in the room as it is way too hot. Do let me know if it interferes with the microphone too much. Put it to the beside me just here. But hopefully it shouldn't interfere too much. Last week was, I think, our second stream of Mass Effect. So we're still pretty early on in the game. With a lot of exploring to do and... well, absolute tons to do. Absolute lots to do. As usual, I've not played this game, so absolutely no spoilers at all. Get all loaded up. There we go. And so we've got Diddlicks already in the chat. Hello Diddlicks, hello Ramses. I'm kind of out of focus. I didn't notice it looked a bit blurry. I wasn't sure if it was just my eyesight going a bit funky for a moment. Why has that gone all funky? How does that look? Slightly better to me. Shouldn't have an autofocus, so it shouldn't actually make a difference. Yeah, I can't mess around with the focus settings or anything, it's all default. Cheeky's got the better camera for that sort of thing. Yeah. Yeah, I did see it when it was on the other screen. Anyway, let's worry less about my ugly mug and more about Albert. Well, logging on in Liara's bedroom. Let's not question that. You know, I don't even remember where we got to. Burla's diplomat needs a Prothean obelisk. Recover it from Shrike Abyssal and deliver it to him at the Citadel Embassy. Priority Palavin. Primarch Federion of the Turian Hierarchy has called a war summit that presents an opportunity for the Alliance to request help. Oh, that's that one there. And then we've got Eden Prime Resistant Movement. Colonists of Eden Prime have fought in the Cerberus occupation, helped the resistant movement by getting them Cerberus intel. How do I do that? Is that just like an ongoing thing? Salute. Salutes like American. Got buffering issues? Let me know if it continues. What are we doing? I ain't got any issues my end. Private. Oh, you're not Kelly. Do I have any messages? No. If you keep getting buffering, I would probably suggest it's the game. And if you keep getting the issues, Diddlix, I'll swap games. It's not an issue at all. I don't mind. Kappa. Where are we? Skepsis. So we got Turian Primarch. I think that one. Do it. Is the sound and everything okay for you guys? There was a fuel depot there. I'm going to turn it up on my headphones, though it does sound a little bit quiet for me. Liara, yes, we're taking you. I changed my mind about that outfit, you look weird. Okay, what do we got? Don't take James? Well, I've only got the choice between Liara and James. I can't take what's-his-face because he's the idiot that almost killed us with the shuttle. Yes, he is the idiot that did that. Quite correct. Right. Upgrade cost 5. Okay, we'll wait. Liara, you got 2 points. You got 4. Fornication, 5 points. Okay. So I can't do auto upgrade for you. Can. Get some points in incendiary. Fair enough. No, the Prothean, he's blacked out. He needs to rest or wrap his head around some stuff or something. Liara, I got no button for you. Okay.
Thank you. Oh no. No. Palavin.
We have an old friend there.
Holy hell. They're getting decimated.
Strongest military in the galaxy, and the Reapers are obliterating it.
Was it like this on Earth?
Yes.
Shepard. I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
Commander, the LZ is getting swarmed.
James, open that hatch.
And stay away from the flight controls. Oh shit, okay, interesting. Now this feels like a war.
Right. Get in, get out. Let's move.
We're here. Reinforcements have arrived, Taurians. Hey, get up there.
If you're looking for command, it's around the corner, past the first barricade.
Roger that. I guess our friend that's down there is on the planet, wherever it is. Is Garrus. I guess it's Garrus. Commander fucking Shepard here to reinforce you. It's either a good thing or a bad thing. Won't let me up there. Rude. Yep. Say that again about the friendly.
Try them again. Try them again. The reinforcements haven't arrived.
Grand report, knowledge of the terrain is our only advantage here, and that's not going to last forever if they keep throwing their forces at us. Hold this area as long as we can. I'm linking my transponder to the live signal monitoring system of the unit's suits. If it goes out, send another unit here ASAP. Holy shit!
Tabestic, get your men up on that north barricade.
Yes, sir!
Sergeant Bardas, find a way to get that comm tower operational.
Sir!
General?
Commander Shepard, heard you were coming, but I didn't believe it. General Corinthus.
I've come to get Primarch Fedori.
Primarch Fedorian is dead.
Oh,
his shuttle was shot down an hour ago as it tried to leave the moon.
That's gonna complicate things.
Shit, why is he dead? Hold your yeah, that's okay. Give me a sit rep.
How bad is it, General?
We just lost about 400 men in half an hour. We set up camps on this moon as an advanced position to flank the enemy. A sound strategy, just
irrelevant.
Exactly. The sheer force of the Reapers seems to make them immune to that sort of tactic. The Primarch and his men found that out the hard way.
Sorry for your loss.
I'm sorry. I hear he was a good man.
And a friend. He would have been an outstanding diplomat.
So what happens now?
The Turian hierarchy provides very clear lines of succession.
Right. General Corinthus?
With such heavy casualties, it's hard for me to be certain who the next Primarch is. Palavin Command will know. However, at the moment, contacting them is impossible. The comm tower is out. Husks are swarming that area. We can't get close enough to repair it.
Don't worry, General. I'll get your tower operational.
That's what I was thinking.
Thank you, Commander. I'll take care of things on this end.
All right, let's go.
Welcome back, Ramses. We've just been dropped into a war zone.
The comm tower, to the left of the main barricade in front of Palavin.
Feels very...
Let's go.
Oh. I actually... regret that. Despite the fact this game is a very serious setting because of the Reaper invasion stuff, I like the fact that it does make you feel like we're, you know, we're very much in jeopardy here. Like, we landed on a hot landing zone, hot LZ, and it's just like, oh my god. Or, you know. It was poorly done, it wouldn't have felt like that to us. I'm just making sure I loot everything before this moon gets blown up, though.
Every serviceable fighter is in the air. ASAP. Got it? Yes, sir. Up and on your left. This is the main barricade.
Roger that. From Commander Hexnar, reference supplies. They sent us winter gear, not sure what they thought we'd do with that kind of gear here, but I suppose we should thank the spirits nonetheless. Power sources can be cannibalized and converted to power our combat gears, filtering units instead. At least it'll be nice not to have those clogging up anymore. I mean, Taurians and humans have always kind of been at each other's throats. Bit of racism and stuff's been chucked about. Now it comes down to it. I mean, I've always liked Garrus, you know, and I've never had an issue with Taurians. I'd happily fight for them, with them.
Husks at the tower, overwhelm them. Good luck.
All right, I'll handle this. Oh, I'm not playing Division. I can't just double spacebar. Sorry, well, I think it was Solarians was mainly involved with that, weren't they? With the Krogans? Okay, I know the Turians helped as well. But I mean, we weren't around when the Krogan were trying to destroy everything, so... I mean, what they did, it's harsh. But I mean, if it meant the survival of everybody, then could it be justifiable? Unethical, definitely. The flipper is that? Well, the flipper's what? There's husks chasing me? They've been in all three games so far.
This panel.
How'd you know that? I mean, seriously, how did you know that? I'm not comfortable sending Liara away, but she's probably the better tech than fly a ship into it face. There were husks. They were husks, the enemies.
Liara, see if you can repair it.
I'll go up and have a look. If you can keep husks from climbing up behind me, I'd appreciate it.
Yes, I will stand here and watch your back.
Ready, James?
Well, yeah. Let's take them.
I missed. I'm gonna die, I think.
Shepard, I've repaired the tower's main satellite connection.
Good girl. I knew I put the right one on the job.
General, do you read? The comm tower is now operational.
Much appreciated, Commander. Contact Palafin Command.
That didn't look nice.
You got something. I'll help you. Your men till I hear from you.
Understood.
Shepard up.
Yeah, I'm trying to get, what Didlik said, I'm trying to get Turian reinforcements to help Earth. Plus, if we get the Turians backing us, if it's us and the Turians saying, look, we need to help Earth rather than being selfish and helping ourselves, the Council might be more willing to help us. But at the same time, I get why the Council are like, we've got to help ourselves, because, I mean, we're at the moment, we're trying to get reinforcements for Earth to help ourselves. So I get it.
Go ahead.
I have information from Palavin Command. Please return ASAP.
I'm on my way.
On our way.
That's what I just said. So yeah, I get why everyone. I mean, if that's, forgive my lack of lore knowledge, but if that's the Turian homeworld, then I get why they're going ham on this moon. Where's your tent? No, it's that one there. It's you, isn't it?
What have you got?
As your partner said, succession is usually simple. But right now, the hierarchy's in chaos. So many dead are MIA.
I need someone. I don't care who. As long as they can get us the Turian resources we need.
I'm on it, Shepard. We'll find you the Primarch.
Hello, is that who I think it is? Oh, it's you, isn't it?
Garrus.
Vicarian, sir. I didn't see you arrive.
At ease, General.
Good to see you again. I thought you'd be on Palavin.
If we lose this moon, we lose Palavin. I'm the closest damn thing we have to an expert on Reaper forces, so I'm advising.
James, this is Garrus Vicarian. He helped me stop the Collectors. He's a hell of a soldier.
Lieutenant, good to see you too, Liara.
Good to see you in one piece, Garrus.
General Corinthus filled me in. We know who we're after.
Palavin Command tells me that the next Primarch is General Adrian Victus.
Victus? His name's crossed my desk.
Know him, Garrus?
I was fighting alongside him this morning. Lifelong military, gets results, popular with his troops. Not so popular with military command. Has a reputation for playing loose with accepted strategy.
It's worse on Earth? I would say it's pretty much worse on everywhere. Okay, playing loose. I guess he's a bit reckless and stuff. Doesn't answer to hierarchy.
What do you mean?
On Tetris, during the uprisings. His squad discovered a Salarian spy ring about the same time the Turian Separatists did. Rather than neutralize the ring, he fell back. He even gave up valuable fortifications which the rebels took.
Then the rebels attacked the Salarians, and when both groups had worn each other down, Victus moved back in. Didn't lose a man.
Bold strategy, but wild behavior doesn't get you advanced up the meritocracy.
Primarch Victus. That should be something to see.
Actually, that sounds smart. If you've got you and two other separate enemies who age, so there's three teams that hate each other on the battlefield, you pull out, let the other two destroy each other like he did, and then you just wipe them all out without losing a single man? That sounds smart to me. Okay, it could have gone very, very wrong. So I guess that's probably where the issue lies. Can we trust him? That is the key.
You think he can get the job done?
We both know conventional strategy won't beat the Reapers. Right now, he could be our best shot. And I trust him.
It's good enough for me.
Let's get him on the shuttle and get out of here.
Commander! Shepard, come in!
Can this wait, Joker? We're in the middle of a war zone.
We've got a situation on the Normandy, Commander. It's like she's possessed. Shutting down systems, powering up weapons. I can't find the source.
I need the Normandy standing by. We may have to bug up.
Should I go back and take a look?
Do it.
No.
Garrus, you said you were with Victus this morning?
Yeah, but we got separated. He went to bolster a flank that was breaking. Could be anywhere out there.
We're trying to raise him, Commander.
Incoming Harvester! Headed for the airfield!
What the fuck is that?
General, tell Primarch Victus we'll rendezvous here. In the meantime, let's go take care of whatever that thing dropped off. Coming, Garrus?
Are you kidding? I'm right behind you.
It's great to have Garrus back, but I'm not keen on... To me, it sounds like there's trouble on the, Normandy. I think that, The Prothean was probably hijacking stuff. That Reedy's just gone crazy. Hey, Katz, how are you? Welcome back. Who's died? No one yet. Well, we lost Morden in the second game. Morden's dead. Trillions of dead. And it's not my doing! I haven't accidentally murdered tens of thousands of people yet. Yeah, we're not going that way. Where are we going? Airfield. They have an airfield?
Hey, are you breathing so hard?
Atmosphere's a little thinner than I'm used to, is all. Adrenaline's better than oxygen any day.
I need that, whatever that is.
Just me? What do those Reapers look like, Turian?
Right. They do.
These are Turian Reapers, then. Oh, they, were making a human Reaper, weren't they, in the second game? Shit, bad time to be caught out in the open without ammo. Why do I have minus one ammo? It makes no sense. Maybe this weapon isn't...
I think we're done here.
Okay, that was... I think if you start in the third game, you can make some of the key choices. Downside is some of the smaller, minor choices that influence the game won't have taken effect. Slightly lost now, though.
Understood.
Sure thing.
What does C
you
do?
Bet. Understood.
I don't know what C does. I meant to push V. Oh, we're going back to the general. Fair enough.
Shepard, come in.
Go ahead.
Still trying to raise the Primarch, but we've got trouble back here at the main barricade. If the Reapers breach it, we're done.
On my way.
I'm already here, love. Oh, hello. Press S. Okay. Mass Effect 4 is Andromeda. They're working on it at the moment, it's in development. Mass Effect 4. Ha ha ha, good fix.
Like fish in a barrel. What?
Oh!
Holy hell! What is that thing?
Why did I fall over? I want the turret, man! I want the turret! Wait, James, why did you follow me down here? You should have stayed on the turret, you fool! I've never played this game at all, cats. So the no spoiler rule is in play.
Primark.
Still can't get a stable comm link.
Okay, I'm going on foot. Shepard out. Garrus, take me to the last place you saw Victus.
A different place, different people? What? That's not Mass Effect. But okay, I suppose if they finish the story in this game, which don't answer that, of course.
How far? Should be pretty quick, unless we find trouble.
Unless we find trouble. Oh, Garrus, you made me laugh.
Damn it. Look at Palavin. That blaze of orange. The big one. That's where I was born.
That's rough.
Still I'm sorry, family man. There?
My dad. A sister.
How bad sister? Is it?
3 million lost the first day. 5 the second.
How's your military holding up?
Look around. That should give you some idea.
You're putting up a good fight.
For now. But how long does it take before the fight's kicked out of them? If they'd only listened to your warnings about the Reapers, we might have been ready.
Maybe. Hard to figure how you prepare for something like this.
You do something instead of turning around and saying, oh, they don't exist. Did do before.
Found more back here. Shit, I hate those things. And New York is crawling with the creepy bastards? I never should have left Earth.
It's gonna be bad all over.
Leaving the fight just pisses me off.
But you're here asking Victus to do the same thing. Leave the fight to make nice in some boardroom.
This summit is the only chance we've got. None of us is beating the Reapers alone.
That's what I mean. We're all trying to...
Soldier, you okay?
Yes, sir. We'll make it.
Have you seen General Victor?
Half hour ago. At himself.
Okay, good luck.
Yes, sir.
Oh, shit!
That was a little closer than I'd like.
I'll say.
Is it worth checking for survivors?
No survivors. Damn it. Crash like that, it's not surprising.
So, Commander, you really think this summit will work? I mean, Asari? Salarians? Where's the Krogan and Batarians? Where's the meat?
It's not that easy.
The Batarians took the first hit when the Reapers arrived. Not much left of them. And the Krogan have never forgiven us for the Genophage.
Right. Turians sterilized them.
Salarians came up with it.
And the Krogan hate them both for it.
So they won't be joining us.
Too bad. I fought with the Krogan. They're tough sons of bitches.
Well, if Rex is still about, we can get him on our side. That background noise, is that coming for us?
Okay, double time. No Reaper's taking this Primarch from me.
Right behind you.
Oh, I have to back in the battle music? Really? It's always bad news. Shinies. Shinies are the priority. Yeah, but we stopped him from murdering people and stuff. He's got a bit of respect for us. Oh shit, there's another brute. What the hell's this? Oh, my face! What the hell's that? Where is it? Dead. What the hell did I just do? Oh shit, I should have saved that. Why not using my... Garrus is down. Keep forgetting I got guys. Garrus. About as intense
General
as they
Victus.
Can.
Yes?
I'm Commander Shepard of the Normandy.
Not Commander. I know who you are.
I can't wait to find out what brings you out here.
Vicarian, where did you go?
Heavy Reaper unit on the right flank. I believe your exact words were, get that thing the hell off my men.
Appreciate it.
General, you're needed off planet. I've come to get you.
It will take something beyond important for me to leave my men or my Turian brothers and sisters in their fight.
Fedorian was killed. You're the new Primarch.
You're needed immediately to chair a summit and represent your people in the fight against the Reapers.
Good night, Ramses. See you later. Take care.
I'm Primarch of Palavin. Negotiating for the Turian hierarchy?
Yes.
I've spent my whole life in the military. I'm no diplomat. I hate diplomats.
You sound perfect. What's your hesitation?
What makes you think you're not qualified?
I'm not really a by-the-book kind of guy, and I piss people off. My family's been military since the Unification War. War is my life. It's in my bones. But that kind of passion is deceptive. Can make you seem reckless when you're anything but.
War is your resume. At a time like this, we need leaders who've been through that hell.
I like that. You're right.
And honestly, uniting these races may take as much strength as facing the Reapers. See this devastation, Primarch? Double that for Earth. I need an alliance. I need the Turian fleet.
Give me a moment to say goodbye to my men.
Without him down here, there's a good chance we lose this moon.
Without him up there, there's a good chance we lose everything.
Look at that. And they want my opinion on how to stop it? Failed CSEC officer, vigilante, and I'm their expert advisor? Think you can win this thing, Shepard?
Yeah, I don't know, Garrus. But I'm sure as hell gonna give it my best shot.
I'm damn sure nobody else can do it. For whatever it's worth, I'm with you.
Welcome aboard.
Again.
Are you ready, Primarch Victus?
One thing. Commander, I appreciate your need for our fleets, but I can't spare them. Not while my world is burning. But if the pressure could be taken off Palavin...
That's a pretty tall order.
We need the Krogan. I can't see us winning this thing without them. Get them to help us, and then we can help you.
The Krogan.
Looks like your summit just got a lot more interesting.
Might as well just ask me to pull a nuke out of my ass while I'm at it.
I apologize for being so frank, Commander, but your plan feels doomed to failure. We know. We've been there before.
But Madam Counselor, let me...
I'm not the only one that feels this way. The Salarian Dalatras is livid.
Some of these issues are hundreds of years old. Time to let go.
Perhaps. Still, we can't help but feel that this summit is a waste of your time, and we can't afford to have it waste ours. We must focus our attention on the arrival of the Reapers. So no, the Asari will not be at your summit.
Our alliance would be stronger with the Krogan. You need them. We all do.
Good luck, Commander. And goodbye.
Commander, Admiral Hackett's available on VidCom.
Ay. What do we tell him? You hope Rex is in a good mood? So do I. Is he in this game? Don't answer that. But that was when it mentioned about the Krogan and that's my first thought. Because he was a clan leader in the second game, weren't he?
Commander, have you retrieved the Primarch for your summit?
Yes, sir. But the Asari are staying on the sidelines.
They'll regret that. The time for unity is now.
The Salarians will be there, though.
You don't sound very optimistic.
We expect the Krogan will be joining us, too.
I see. Well, then you've got your hands full, Commander. Was there something else you needed to discuss?
Any updates on Cerberus?
There's still the wild card here. Hitting the archives on Mars suggests they're after the same thing we are. a way to defeat the Reapers.
It didn't seem as if the Elusive Man was suggesting we appease them. Not like Saren did. You'd think we'd be on the same side, now more than ever.
Cerberus has never played by the rules as we know them. I don't know what their agenda is, but it has nothing to do with humanity's best interests.
The Elusive Man talked about controlling the Reapers. He seemed to think that's how we win this.
He's wrong. Dead Reapers are how we win this.
Doesn't mean he won't try.
I saw your report on that Cerberus soldier you found on Mars. If the Elusive Man is good at one thing, it's finding new ways to subvert science. It's never worked for him before, and it won't now.
How's Earth?
Have you pieced together how the Reapers hit Earth?
It wasn't all that complicated, really. They surged through the relays and hit Arcturus Station before we knew what was happening. From there, it was a short jump to the Sol system. Earth didn't stand a chance.
Sending us to the Mars Archives was a good call.
Still doesn't make up for the fact that the Reapers nailed us to the wall. I sacrificed the entire Second Fleet to provide cover for the Third and the Fifth to retreat. Hell, I presided over the most devastating military defeat in human history.
Don't beat yourself up, man. We're still in this.
Nothing more, sir.
Keep me posted. Hack it out.
Don't beat yourself up. We are still in this. We are doing our utmost best. Who are you? Oh. Of course. Whoops. Any new? I was just about to ask.
Edie just went offline.
What do you mean offline?
I don't know. She's not responding, and I can't access the AI core diagnostics. You better get down to deck 3.
I was just about to ask.
Comm systems are going haywire. Whatever's happening is centered on deck 3.
See if you can get to Edie. I'll check the AI core.
I was just about to ask, did they fix the thing with the ship? Deck 3. Who's on deck 3, I wonder?
Shepard, what's happening?
Something's in the AI core.
Edie, you'd better go quickly. I'll check on my own computers.
Running safe mode diagnostics, please stand by.
I'm guessing it's the Prothean. Where's the, Oh, it's in the med bay. Oh, no, wait, no, it's not. What am I... No, I'm an idiot. It's not the Prothean. Get back! She's in there! Are you wearing a gas mask?
Automated systems have the fires contained. It should be safe to enter. We'll follow your lead.
Joker, what's that sound?
Fire extinguishers, Commander. Could be an electrical fire, or something.
I'm going in.
Put her in there.
Edie, talk to me.
Yep, I forgot about her.
Is there a particular topic you wish to discuss? Shepard.
Edie?
Yes.
You're in Dr. Eva's body.
Not all of me, but I have control of it. It was not a seamless transition.
A transition? You blacked out on us for a while there.
Correct. When we brought this unit on board, I began a background process to search for its information on the Prothean device. This eventually triggered a trap. A backup power source and CPU activated, and the unit attempted physical confrontation. Fortunately, I was able to gain root access and repurpose it as I saw fit. During this process, it struggled. thus the fire.
That was dangerous, Edie.
Edie, you need to alert us about incidents like this. You shouldn't have done this alone.
Bringing the crew up to speed would have been counterproductive. All attempts to help would have been limited by reaction time.
So if you're in there, are you still in the ship?
I exist primarily within the ship. For optimal control, this unit should remain within Normandy's broadcast or tight beam range.
Are you planning to take that body somewhere?
Normandy's weaponry is not suited to every combat situation. This platform could provide limited fire ground support.
You mean you could come with us?
Correct. This body could accompany you to areas the Normandy cannot reach.
Damn, I never even thought of that. Well, we need to test that first.
Before we do that, I need you to guarantee this mech doesn't have any more surprises in it. Run whatever tests you can. Then we can talk about using it in combat situations.
One moment. I am running trials. Complete. I can send you a full report if you wish. However, my first step should be restoring functionality to the Normandy to reassure the crew that all is normal.
Just don't be surprised if the crew is a little wary of your new body. It was shooting at them a little while ago.
An excellent point. I will take it to the bridge. Joker will also want to see it.
On that, we can agree.
Wow. I did not see that coming. I thought she woke up and... tried to go postal on us and kill us all.
There is new information on the private messages terminal.
Don't like Edie or the Normandy so much in this game. How come? Edie, because they're playing on the sex bot cliche. Alright, okay. Best thing, this Prothea must have... Oh, hang on. Entry 2, entry 1. Things this Prothean must have seen if they had the technology to preserve someone for over 50,000 years. No wonder they were capable of building things like the device on Mars. I must give him time to get his bearings, but goddess, when will we get another chance to learn so much about this civilization? Attached notes on Prothean. Not sure what to make of Javik. I approached him while we were traveling to a different system, but he wasn't very inclined to talk. What little he does say concerns the Reapers and our possible failure. Is he simply a soldier warning his people, or is it a fundamental difference in our cultures? Uh-oh. Good legs. Poor Albert. He hurt his ears. Alliance Interrogator 1. Ugh, check out these implants she's got jammed into her face. Alliance Interrogator 2. Shh, she's awake. Service operative, unintelligible. Hello, do you know where you are? Intelligible. You know how much goddamn trouble you're in? Hey, ease up. Listen, you're in trouble, I'm not going to lie. But that doesn't mean we can't work something out. If you help us, we can. Explosion. Ah, cough. You okay? I'm okay, cough, but holy hell, she's dead. What? Whole front of her face is gone, some kind of ocular flashbang? Oh shit, is everyone in Cerberus rigged up like that? Shit. Yeah, I think they are. Hello.
A Prothean. A living, breathing Prothean right below me.
He's not what I expected.
Me neither. He was a little... cold when I tried to talk. I understand the shock of waking up again. His species gone. But a Prothean, Shepard. There's so much he could tell us.
Something on your mind?
Just old memories. I spent a few weeks on Palavin's South Peaks when I was very, very young. A Turian there teased me a little, saying that the mountains went on forever. I remember believing him. When I looked up at Palavin from its moon, I saw those same mountains burning.
Any upgrades? Nope. Okay. I'll be back. Alright, let's go find the Krogan. He just spoke to me then, I just...
Commander, are you alright? It was fairly intense up here. I can only imagine what it was like down on that moon.
I thought you'd be more concerned about Edie.
Edie is a huge asset to this team. If she'd told me about her plan to obtain a body, I'd have volunteered to help.
I did not wish to force a conflict of interest between our friendship and your duty.
I'd have preferred a conflict of interest to a hard restart of half our systems. But thanks, regardless. While you're here, though, I found something while scanning Alliance channels. Grissom Academy is requesting help. The Reaper invasion front will hit them soon.
Grissom Academy?
I thought the war would close most schools.
Grissom Academy is more specialized than a normal school. It's home to some of the smartest students humanity has to offer. Their Ascension Project is the best training facility in the galaxy for human biotics.
Yes, I sent a young man named David Archer there. I'm just surprised they're still open.
Some of their work has Alliance support. That might be why they stayed.
Who was it we sent there? Was it that guy, the crazy guy that was trying to kill Jack? Or that Jack loyalty thing? Is that him, David Archer? I know we sent someone there. I think it might have been him. Yes, we'll definitely have to help them.
What can we do?
A Turian evac transport responded to their distress call, so normally I'd say we don't need to do anything. But something sounded off in the Turian signal. I had Edie perform an analysis. It's fake. Edie thinks it's Cerberus. She said the fake Turian signal was similar to the one that lured you to a collectorship?
Long story.
In any event, whoever faked the signal wants us to think Grissom Academy's being evacuated, but I believe they're still in danger.
Nice work.
Good catch.
If this really is Cerberus, hopefully this operation is something worth investigating. It could be simple disinformation.
Trainer, good catch.
Thank you, Commander.
I like her accent. Why am I going here? Oh, hello. This address valid. Shepard, I've called and I've sent messages but got no response. With Earth's comm system out, I don't expect this would get through either. But I heard a rumor the Normandy docked here at the Citadel. Are you alive? I'm at Huerta Memorial Hospital under the name Tana Nurara. Please excuse the moniker, but this email's encryption. In my line of work, it is unwise to advertise my location, particularly when I'm not good in good health. Should meet before circumstances force us apart again. Thane. Is that the... Oh, that's him. Yeah, I know him. He's the guy that... the assassin. Commander, my name is John Dunbao. I am with Special Tactics and Recon, your Spectre. While some still have concerns about your past activities with Cerberus, many of us in STNR took your warnings about the Reapers seriously. I'm reaching out to you because I have information that could tie agents with significant political power to the Reapers. If you have time to meet me in the Citadel Embassy, I would appreciate your discreet assistance. Some missions have invisible time limits in this game. Okay. If you're referring to that mission the British Czech just gave us, we're going on that one now. Me, a Spectre from Ashley Williams. Commander, I don't know how to say this. Udina wants me to be a Spectre. Crazy, I know. I'm not a big fan of Udina, but he can make the Spectre thing happen. He's pressing me for an answer, but I don't know what to tell him. I'm too sore to get out of bed and this gets dropped on me. I told him I'd think about it. If you find yourself near the Citadel, I'll drop by at the hospital. I'm getting a little stir crazy here. From Aria to Loke. I have a proposition for you, Shepard. You won't want to pass it up. I'm in a nightclub on the Citadel called Purgatory. Don't wait too long, Aria. Oh, my lord. See, now, that invisible time limit thing I don't like. Because sometimes I just want to, like, do my own thing for a while. I don't like being rushed. It's kind of why I've never played the Dead Rising games, even though I like zombie games, because you're rushed. You've got like 24 actual hours to complete the game kind of thing. In Dead Rising 2, you've always got to be getting medication and stuff, and rescue the students. And I sometimes just like to explore or muck about a bit. Right, let's go. We can take Jarvik with us. I'm gonna take Liara as well. I want to see if they have any conversation between each other. Not sure about Edie. Kinda concerned about taking a robot. Right. For me, Jarvik, have your own wifel. You can have your own wifel. Oh wow. Sorry, rifle magazine upgrade increases rounds per minute by 40. Well, that's useless for no one. Allows bullets to pierce 0.5 meter thick objects. Reduce damage, no. Sniper rifle spare thermal clip increases spare shot capacity by 50%. Add sockets to increase thermal clip capacity, increasing number of spare shots. Ooh, increases accuracy by 20% and helps aim through smoke. Nice. Take that. Skill. Ooh, hello skills. Right, what do we got? Increase shield recharge delay by 15% or increase melee damage by 75% for 30 seconds after an enemy is killed by heavy melee. We'll go with shields. Can I do this? I can. Increase health and shield bonuses or increase melee damage bonus. Increase weapon damage. And we'll go with health and stuff. Okay, here we go.
And there's the folks who answered the distress call. Cerberus cruiser. At least a dozen fighters on blockade duty. Not too many for us in a straight-up fight. They must want this place bad.
Receiving incoming transmission.
Let's hear it.
SSB Normandy, this is Kaylee Sanders, director of Grissom Academy. We need immediate assistance. Cerberus is attacking the facility. They're after my students.
This is Commander Shepard. We're blocked on a direct approach.
I know. They've taken control of our docking base.
Any alternatives?
There's an auxiliary cargo port I could probably open.
All right. We'll come in by shuttle and get your students out of there. Joker, can you give me a diversion?
Oh boy, can I?
He's been waiting for this sort of thing, hasn't he? Oh, Normandy's had a baby. going to do run interference for us, is he? Love it. Joker is awesome. That's right, he's got to be the man you want if you've got to do evasive maneuvers.
Keep the shuttle in position. We'll be back.
Sanders, we're clear. It's me.
Commander, thank you. Admiral Anderson always said you were the best. And with Cerberus coming for my students, I need the best.
How many of you are there?
Fewer than 20. Most were sent home when word of the Reaper invasion spread. But a few volunteered to stay. Some are prototyping tech for the Alliance. Others are biotics. They've been training for military operations, working together as biotic artillery.
Anderson?
You said something about Admiral Anderson.
Yes. We met, God, what's it been? 20 years ago when he was a Spectre candidate. I was there when Saren betrayed him. David saved my life that day. He's a good man.
He was on Earth when the Reapers hit. He stayed behind when I got off world.
I hadn't heard. We've been cut off from most news. He's alive?
Alive and fighting. He's currently leading the resistance movement.
Good. If we get out of here, well, just tell him to stay alive.
Of course. Tell him about the students.
A few months knocking over practice dummies can't prepare your students for war.
Agreed, but the Alliance needs every resource it can get. And our students are unique resources. They wanted to help. How could we say no with the entire galaxy falling apart? Hang on. I've been trying to get communications working.
This is Froberg. There are students trapped in Orion Hall. Cerberus has us boxed in. They're closing fast.
Damn it.
Orion Hall?
Back out the door and down the hallway. I can get the door open.
I'll bring them back here and we'll make a run for the shuttle.
Thank you, Commander. I'll stay put. With luck, I can regain control of some of our systems.
Think she's spinning? Yeah. And picture him.
I'll get the door for you. It leads to Orion Hall.
You better hope I don't catch you up. I'm with the Alliance. You're okay.
There may be more nearby. Play dead until it's safe, then get to Kaylee Sanders at security.
Okay, but my sister Sean is out here somewhere too.
Yeah. On the share, go back. How far back am I going? Is that what you meant? Ammo? I don't need ammo. A good shout though. No, no, it's fine. I sometimes miss shinies, and I don't want to miss all the good shinies, so...
Thank you.
like that sort of stuff. Nom, nom, nom. Okay, now I'm confused. Oh. Taz Glanis with review, student ID, hashtag 275668. Shielding opponent approaching at 2 o'clock, shielded opponent approaching at 12 o'clock, both holding heavy pistols. Most effective way to take them down, you choose shockwave. Correct answer, singularity wave followed by a warp. Instructor comments. Shockwave inadequate against shielded enemy, your barrier would hold long enough against heavy pistols for a singularity to catch both. Warp on the unstable biotic field created by the singularity results in an explosion neutralizing both enemies. Tractor's log, kids are getting better at this shit, but I'm worried. I don't think we've got enough time to pull this off, and there's just no way they could really survive out there without way more training, not without any field experience at all. Don't want best to get them ready. Didn't think I'd ever care this much, but I won't let anyone hurt them. They're my kids. Mine. It's a little bit possessive. See for that bloody smoke. I'm sorry. Sniper rifles the smoke mod? I know it does. I added it on. Hello. I'll take it. So far, they've always been better. Long range shotgun. Found your brother.
Shepard, we need to help her.
Sean, can you hear me?
You know my name.
I saved your brother. He's with Kaylee Sanders at security. Can you get to her?
Yeah. I just need to rest for a minute. Thank you.
Genomic visor.
Jack!
Shepard?
Jack? Where did you come from? And I like the fact you're kind of wearing some clothes this time around. I didn't like how little she's wearing in the second game. Doing. Seriously, what do you think I'm doing? Like, okay, let's give this a go. Uh, Trying to. I'm kind of dealing with an Atlas here. Okay, max down. Hey, happy moment, how are you this evening?
Kaylee said she was putting out an SOS. I had no idea the King of the Boy Scouts would show up. Alright, amp check. Prangley, those fields were weak. Cerberus isn't gonna lie down out of pity like that girl you took to prom. Grab juice and an energy bar. We move in five.
That's the teacher?
Damn it. How many times did I tell you not to trust Cerberus?
You're the teacher? Oh, now I've seen everything.
You're not telling me anything I haven't told myself, Jack.
Oh, you feel bad? Well, shit. That makes up for giving him the damn collector base.
I'd forgotten how angry she was.
Whereas I barely remember you at all, Blue.
Your real first name is Jennifer. I can find your last name if you ask politely.
Okay. Right now, all I care about is getting my guys out of here.
Your guys?
Yeah. I guess so.
I can't think of anybody who could care about them more.
Well, I had some free time while you were off playing hero. Alliance Brass knew I helped you. They offered me this. And apparently the students responded well to my teaching style.
The psychotic biotic!
I will destroy you! Drink your juice, Rodriguez. You couldn't destroy wet tissue paper.
Cortez to extraction team. The Cerberus cruiser is coming back.
How long have we got?
2 minutes tops, Commander. After that, there's no way we'll get past them.
Get out of here and back to the Normandy. We'll find another way off the station.
Roger that. Good luck, sir.
Shepard to Sanders. The students are safe, but the shuttle's a no-go.
Understood. I might know another way off the station, but I need station-wide camera access. Can you disable the Cerberus security override? It's routed through Orion Hall, so it should be nearby.
How does camera access get us off this station?
We need to reach the Cerberus shuttles. The cruiser won't auto-target friendly ships, which gives us a fighting chance to escape. Get me back the cameras, and I'll find a path to the shuttles that keep Cerberus from boxing you in.
Okay.
You really think we're getting out of here?
Well, of course we are. Don't talk about that.
Sorry. So, our teacher worked with Commander Shepard? That's pretty badass.
How's your aunt?
Hot. I think I pulled a muscle in my brain.
Just drink your juice. You'll be fine.
Okay, I'm going this way then, I guess. Just making sure I got all the shinies. Good day, Jack. Hi, Jack.
Hey. Let me know when we've got a new way off this station.
I have to say, Jack, you look good.
Yeah, well, maybe some of your attitude rubbed off on me. I never had a family. And these guys... Anyone screws with my students, I will tear them apart.
How are the students handling the war?
How do you think? They're a bunch of teenagers. Until a few months ago, the biggest concern was getting laid.
You don't think they're ready for war?
I don't think they have a choice.
So, all this talk about biotic artillery strikes.
It's great in theory. Maybe they'll get it together once they've seen some action.
But?
They'd be better off as support. Put them in the back ranks, helping with barriers and shit. I don't know.
Have you told them that?
No. They need me to believe in them. I did pick up a few things listening to your damn speeches.
What's so valuable about these students? Biotically, I mean.
Well,
What's scarier than a pissed-off biotic attacker? A whole bunch of them working together. It's like a biotic artillery strike. Any asshole gets in our way, we rip him to shreds.
Isn't that the kind of thing you wanted to destroy on Pragya?
You know damn well it wasn't. Cerberus was torturing kids on Pragya. These guys are older, and they volunteered, and the only ones feeling any pain are the bad guys.
Fair enough.
Stay close. We'll get you out of here.
Good.
Any more FTL streams? I'm not sure yet. Sure, schedule's pretty full. I'm looking at possibly mixing some things around. All the games at the moment are all story-driven, so... there's the camera control. High priority target, student ID 12-5D-Prangley. Status capture priority alpha, bring back alive at all costs. Vital retrieval subject due to high level biotic abilities paired with high leadership testing scores. Consider prime candidate for indoctrination and high level enhancements for subsequent long term infiltration relocation.
Sent. Should have access.
Got it. The fastest way is through the atrium, but Cerberus has sealed the doors. You'll need to disable the magnetic locks. The overrides should be directly above the door.
Where am I going? Which door am I going? Atrium. I'm guessing it's this way, because this is kind of like... The overrides is above it, so it's probably in the room up here.
We hear Cerberus saying people's names? They must have files on all of us.
What? Who pick a file on you? Your biotic can barely lift 100 kilos.
Yeah, but at least I passed biomathematics.
Got it.
You should be able to force the door open now. I'll get to the shuttles ahead of you and get a pair ready to fly.
Awesome. A pair? Get an apple as well.
Everyone be ready. We'll go in first and draw their fire.
We'll shadow you from the second level and hit those guys from above.
A useful tactic. They would avoid direct fire.
Just time your shots and stay safe.
All right. I didn't bust my ass training you so you could die now. Keep low, pick your targets.
Students of Grissom Academy, the station is sealed. The Alliance soldiers cannot save you. All they can do is get you killed. Surrender peacefully and you won't be harmed.
Asshole.
Damn it, they're messaging everyone. Students, switch your Omni tools to privacy mode so they can't track you.
What if they're not lying?
You can do this, guys. Trust me.
You've already held your own against Cerberus. You've been trained for this by one of the best.
Come on, Rodriguez. They're only asking nicely because you scared them in that last fight. So take your balls out of your purse and kick some ass.
Yes, ma'am.
Let's go.
Can't argue with Jack, you really can't. Got another mech. Damn it, with all this smoke already.
Hell yeah.
times do I need to reload this gun, man? Hey, Cadenzaro, how are you this evening? You're the Protean. They're okay up there. I'm doing okay, thank you. How was that? Oh, it reached a- oh! Shiny. Brief, high priority targets 12-5D-Prangley, 26-2B-Rodriguez. Other subjects are to be retrieved alive if possible. If unavoidable, bring back bodies for use as genetic testing materials. Addendum to original brief. Subject 0 is to be retrieved for further testing and possible conditioning. Current site profile indicates holding students hostage likely to be most successful tactic.
Kaylee, we're in the atrium.
Okay up there?
Rodriguez took one in the arm because she didn't watch her barrier.
Commander, I've reached the Cerberus shuttles without being detected. They know what they're doing, though. You need to hurry.
Oh, hello. Didn't watch her barriers, apparently. Just use my squad mate powers. I'd kind of leave them to be, kind of let them be automatic. Lift grenade. Fair enough. That's actually kind of nice. We got them running.
Impressive barrier, Octavia. Our file says you've been working on shield technology. Fire!
I'm Commander Shepard with the Alliance. I'm here to help.
I didn't buy it from the last guy, and I've got no reason to buy it now.
The square root of 906.01 equals...
30.1.
Hello, Commander Shepard.
David, you know him?
Yes.
Oh.
He rescued me from Cerberus. Sent me here. He made it quiet.
You did a great job keeping yourself safe. The biotic students are up there. Stay close. They'll get you out of here.
Okay. Thanks.
I'm glad he's okay.
Has Grissom Academy been all right?
Yes. I've been counting.
Anything in particular?
The number of days you lengthened my life. The security office. I hacked the lock. Guns. Lots of guns. Goodbye.
Shit. I remember him. That was... I thought it was the guy from Jack's... mission at first, because we sent him somewhere. I'm glad he's okay.
Looks like schematics for amp interfaces. Not as good as what we already have, but still worth a look.
Picked up one of your favorite guns? Well, I'll see how it works. Are you seriously suggesting what I think you're suggesting? Because I am totally up for that. I am, however, needing a very quick break because I've just kind of remembered something rather important. I haven't put my uniform in the wash. Be right back. I'm back, thank you very much for waiting. Can't believe I completely forgot about that. Beep boop. We're gonna use this.
Yeah.
Don't worry about my ass, love. Okay, I'm crap with the rockets, let's just not use them.
Hostiles up top!
Cerberus bits. Oops, that didn't happen. That was.
The shuttles are almost ready.
Oh shit! Where the hell's that rocket launcher? Down, sir. Who the hell just murdered my girlfriend? I will kill you. Oh, hello. Can't kill me, I'm indestructible. You okay? Do I have to get out of this?
Hurry, Commander. The Normandy has pulled the cruiser out of position. We need to leave now.
Yeah, we're going. Go, go, go.
Kaylee, how's it coming?
Shuttles are unlocked.
Take the controls and get the students aboard.
Wait, where the hell's Rodriguez?
Sorry, Rodriguez.
She needs covering fire.
She needs more than that.
Joker, we flew out on a Cerberus shuttle. Watch your fire.
Right, I've got you on sensors. Should just be a minute.
Thank you, Commander. We'd have never gotten off that station if you hadn't come.
Forget that. We kicked some ass. Next place we dock, you're all getting inked. My treat. What do you guys want? Ascension Project logo? Glowing fist? Maybe a unicorn for Rodriguez? Screw you, ma'am!
I can't believe we got them out alive. I was going to suggest that they stick to support roles, but perhaps they're ready after all.
Ah, don't! No! I want no part in this decision. No. Jack has hair now? She does indeed. Kinda like the way her hair is. I do not want to be making that decision. I mean, they've only just had their first battle. Everyone, yeah, but putting them in support, they're still going to be involved. They're just supporting. I mean, obviously, you know, Diddlix, I always play a support role in games, whether it's a medic or an engineer, placing turrets and stuff, whatever the game. I always play support. Support is essential. But they've been trained for battle. And if you turn around and tell them they're now support, it might upset their feelings, okay? Feelings in war are irrelevant. But morale is a thing. No. They did okay in battle. One got wounded. But it was their first... Ah, sod it. It's war. Well, they've had their first mission, so to speak. Oh, I hate this. I'm gonna have to stick them in support. I'm gonna stick them in support. They're not gonna like me for it. No, I won't. Put a Spectre as support? And hey, Ragnar. My condolences, by the way, Ragnar. I am very sorry that your homeland got invaded. I did what I could. Oh, miserably.
They're definitely ready, but the Alliance needs them in a support role.
What? We trained for artillery strikes.
We don't need another artillery unit. We need stronger barriers for our frontline squads.
This is bullshit!
Hey, if that's where they need us, that's where we go. Besides, I'm sure we'll get some shots in.
Commander, we've got a visual on you now. Preparing to dock. Hey, Jack, now that you're military, you gonna wear a uniform, or are you just getting the officer's bars tattooed on?
Screw you, Flight Lieutenant.
What the hell was that?
Jack promised to watch your language in order to maintain the necessary professionalism we need from our teachers.
What, does she have a swear jar or something? Because I bet if we empty that thing, we can afford another cruiser.
Cover your ears, kids. Hey, Joker.
Shepard, damned if you aren't a sight for sore eyes.
Good to see you too, sir.
Sir? I may have reinstated you, but that doesn't give you permission to go all formal on me.
Then I'm glad you managed to keep your ass alive, Anderson.
That's more like it. Looks like you didn't waste any time getting to work. I can only imagine what would have happened to those kids if they'd fallen into Cerberus' hands.
They're definitely eager to help.
These students are some of the best humanity has to offer, and we're throwing them into battle. God damn it, I hate this war. Hackett didn't mention in his report...
Kaylee Sanders is safe. She's with the recruits.
Thanks, Shepard. When I heard about the attack, well, I've already lost a lot of friends.
She asked me to tell you to stay alive.
Did she now? Well, thanks, Shepard. That might be the first good news I've heard this week. Anderson out.
Yeah, it's hot here as well. I got my fan on. I've just turned it up. Let me know if it interferes with the mic or anything. And, hey, Guru, how are you? It is very hot, though. Got a headache coming on. Sad to miss stuff, but you gotta go to sleep. Aw, Didlick, she said you were gonna stay up late. Not artillery as in long-range attacks and stuff, just using their biocs to use strikes and stuff. It interferes with the mic? Okay, I'll turn it off. No, it doesn't? Oh, just to see Walla's... No, that's mean. I'll turn off the camera and then take off my shirt.
I'm amazed the turrets are fine. The birds don't quit when things get ugly. I'll give them that.
But yeah, I...
You have an encrypted message from a... Miranda Lawson.
Miranda? Wow. What's she up to these days? From Stephen Hackett, forwarded message from Kaylee Sanders. Hi, Commander. I don't have the time to thank you properly. After you got us out of the academy, the Admiral Hackett agreed to send this your way. While my students are out on duty, I'm doing what I can to help with the Crucible. It's an amazing project, more advanced than anything I've ever seen before. Some of my more tech-minded kids are staying back to help out too. I'm watching them work. It's the future, Commander. This project will inform human progress for generations, and they'll have you to thank for it. Alright, good night, Diddlex. Good night. Sleep well. It's Cheeky's bedtime soon. Oh, he's already asleep. He's asleep and I've got to wake him up by putting the covers on him. Commander, I heard about your stay with the Alliance. I can only imagine what nonsense they cooked up to keep you there. We should talk. It's safer in person. You can find me on the Citadel by Bay D24, Miranda. Okay? She's probably busy finding tighter suits to fitting. She probably has, to be honest. I declined to comment. But it is hot. It is very hot. It's Miranda, look what they did to Ashley. That is actually a fair point. They sexualized Ashley. What are they going to do with Miranda? And she was already kind of half-sexualized in the previous game.
We are transferring your docking clearance to an Alliance official.
Figures. Finally back in action, the Alliance already wants us tagged and collared.
Just our way of welcoming you back, Flight Lieutenant.
Yes, ma'am. Requesting docking permission?
Docking permission granted. Would you like private transport arranged?
I need to get to the hospital.
Yes, Commander.
Oh, wow, they can...
We're at this little farm. We killed a few enemy scouts, and it's quiet. The shuttle gets called away for support, so I'm there for the night. The humans get me dinner, show me around. One of them, this freckled farm girl, maybe 15. She wants to hear all about what it's like to be a commando.
You were probably the most exciting thing ever to land at her farm.
Yeah. She's saying she wants to be a pilot, and I say that life on a ship is grimy. And she asks if I'd like to use their shower.
Going by my records, you'd been on active duty for more than 3 weeks. Probably no real chance to get clean in all that time.
Pretty much, yeah.
So you're a smelly Asari?
Yes, I'm trying to place a call to Grissom Academy. They have biotic amp interfaces. I may be able to adapt for Asari use. No, it won't connect. It says the station's communication system is offline.
I overheard you talking. Grissom Academy is gone. But I found this while I was there.
What is this? Yes, these are tailored to human physiology. But with a few alterations, they should work for the Asari as well. This is exactly what I needed. Thank you.
Talk to the doc? Which doc? The psychic doc? The psychiatrist doc?
I'm in the shower with hot water and everything. And that's when Neaira came.
Neaira was another huntress on your ship?
Yeah, a friend. I wanted it to be more than that, but she had a medical condition.
It's okay. It's in the file.
The farm girl calls in to me that another Asari is here. I thought the shuttle had gotten back early. I come out in a towel and Neaira walks through the door. But it wasn't her. Not anymore.
No, our doc? We have a doc? Who's our doc? Nope, we don't have one.
Listen to me, those prototypes are vital. We need these biotic upgrades to fight the Reapers.
I know Peter is my frontier, is it safe?
Yes.
Doctor. Doctor who? No.
This project costs you nothing. Thank you very much for your time.
This Twitch delay thing's frustrating because you're like, oh, no, go back, and by then I've already walked like somewhere else, and it's just like, no.
I'd like an answer, Lieutenant Commander. The galaxy has need of exceptional soldiers like you, now more than ever.
I still need time. You'll have my answer soon, I promise.
I look forward to it. Shepard?
Udina.
Udina, I got your email. Made your decision yet?
On becoming a Spectre? Not yet. It's an honor and all. But I don't know. I need to think about it some more.
It's a big decision. Smart to give it some thought. How are you doing?
Good, considering. The nurse said you checked in on me earlier. Still out cold, I guess.
We didn't have time to talk. I thought maybe if you were up for it.
Yeah, I wasn't sure you wanted to. You were pretty clear on Mars about where things stood.
What do you mean?
You're not a part of Cerberus anymore. Case closed. Full stop.
It's the truth.
Okay. You cut all ties. I accept that. It's just that if you're giving the orders, I need to be able to count on you.
Did I buy her a gift? No, I forgot about that.
That works both ways. It's a damn mess out there. All we've got is the people around us. We have to trust each other or this doesn't work. Deal?
Buy her a tighter suit.
Deal.
Okay. Get some rest. You need anything at all, let me know.
Shepard, wait. There's one more thing. I wasn't sure if I should mention it.
What is it?
I have family back on Earth. I haven't heard from them. It's making me crazy. But I know you're busy, Shepard. We can talk later.
I've got time to talk. I didn't hear from you while I was a guest of the Alliance.
I couldn't face you. Even when Anderson requested my presence, it was difficult.
It's okay. We're past that. Fresh start.
It's gonna take time.
Copy that. But not too long. The bad guys aren't taking coffee breaks.
Okay. What is this? Healing through guilt?
Seems to be working. So, what's all this Lieutenant Commander business?
Seems like the old Williams curse is losing its grip. Was sure I'd top out at Gunnery Chief.
You've worked hard. You deserve it.
I thought so too. Until Eden Prime. Losing 212 was... well, you know.
It was the Reapers, Ash. You did the best you could, and survived to help us.
Just losing everyone under my command, it's tough to face. I'll never forget any of them.
Right now, we need you back on your feet.
I'll be back.
Grr.
And first order of business is to shove their metal tentacles right up there. I'll fight with honor and courage, sir.
Roger that, LC. Who's back on Earth?
Mom plus my three sisters. The youngest, Sarah, was away on her honeymoon. Married a military man, Thomas. He got called back in and she was stuck alone. She called me. It's been pretty tough.
I imagine.
I was always there to protect them growing up. Even when I was off on tour, they knew they could talk to me. I told her to come to the Citadel. We could wait for news together.
We can't afford to be at each other's throats. If we plan on getting through this, we need to trust each other.
I was trying to keep the family stuff to myself, to be professional. I don't know how you managed to keep it all together.
I have my moments, believe me.
You know, I'm glad to hear it.
Have you heard anything about Earth?
We have reports coming all the time on what's going on. Half are wild speculation, and half are probably too optimistic to be true.
We have to believe that we can do something.
When I thought you were dead, I lost hope. I'm telling you. But when you came back, I was ready to believe anything. I mean, maybe this problem can't be solved by some grunt shooting the boogeyman in the face. But if you think it might help, I'm game.
That sounds more like the Ash I know. I should get back to it. Take care of yourself.
You too, Shepard.
I'll buy those gifts now, just in case we've got more dialogue. Oh, hang on, we've got more dialogue. We'll buy the gifts. You reckon we should get her a tighter suit?
It's completely tasteless to call this place Huerta Memorial.
President Huerta died of a stroke 2 years ago, ma'am.
I think you meant to say the man was dead for an hour and a half and his political enemies piled on enough propaganda to get the hospital name changed.
He can't remember his own name without the VI in his head telling him what it is. Trust me, in this building, we know dead.
The Supreme Court says he's alive.
Five justices say he's alive. Two of them appointed by him. The name is what it is.
It's completely tasteless to call this place Huerta Memorial.
President Huerta died of a stroke 2 years ago, ma'am.
I think you meant to say the man was dead for an hour and a half and his political enemies piled on enough propaganda to get the hospital name changed.
I don't know what that's all about.
Welcome to Serta.
You can't get the gifts.
Thank you for coming to Serta.
Be safe.
How can we help you?
Court says he's alive.
Five justices say he's alive.
Can't get the gifts.
By him. The name is what it is.
It's completely tasteless.
Hello. Shit.
Listen to me, those prototypes are vital. We need these biotic upgrades.
The colony is across the galaxy from Paladin and Earth. The United Force appears to be the same that attacked those.
I don't need these Mark Frontiers.
Guessing it's this one here. Nope. I thought he was at hospital. Thane, I thought Thane was in hospital. Or am I just tripping?
She's got this glow. And the Reapers. They did to her what they do to everyone. She's covered in, I don't know, glowing. She reaches out. Her eyes go black. She touches one of the farmers, and he just dies. They panic. She rips them apart, sometimes touching, sometimes opening them up with biotics. The humans are turning into liquid. And I'm there, in my towel with no gun. And husks start pouring through the door.
Goddess.
So I ran.
Ah, there he is.
Commander Shepard, when I heard Earth was under attack, I tried to call. I never got through.
Thane, good to see you staying in shape.
My disease kills slowly. With enough care and a healthy lifestyle, it can be delayed for a few years. Of course, my allotted time has come and gone. Now I exercise because it pleases me. What are you doing here?
Visiting a friend who got hurt protecting me. Ashley.
The dark-haired human woman in intensive care. She will be starting physical therapy with my class soon.
That's her.
If she means something to you, then I will help how I can. As long as she is here, consider her under my protection.
I appreciate it, Thane.
I am near the end of my life. It is a good time to be generous. Kepril syndrome has put most of my other plans on hold.
Do you know how much time you have left?
I've been to several doctors. My favorite gave me 3 months to live. 9 months ago. It's freeing to find no requirements placed on me. No responsibilities. No fears. It is a good end to a life.
Are you in a lot of pain?
At times. The oxygen transfer proteins don't form correctly. Your human equivalent would be hemoglobin. As a result, my blood is low in oxygen. No matter how much I breathe in, I get tingling, numbness, and that is the best of it. As for my brain, I cannot track the damage. I just experience dizziness from time to time.
I'm back on the Normandy on an important mission. Sure could use you.
I would not be as I was before. I need daily medical attention. And if I know you, you will want to fight the Reapers somehow. You need the best at your side. And I am not at mine.
You don't have to wrestle down Krogan and break their necks. I'm sure we could find you lighter work.
I am at peace with what I've done in my life, Shepard. There comes a time when one must rest from war and conflict. It is not your time, but it is mine.
I wish the best for you, Thane.
And I for you. Do not grieve for me. I have good doctors. My son visits regularly. Perhaps we will keep up via the extranet now that you are free. Until we meet again, Shepard.
I'm glad his son visits him. I was going to ask about his son, but there was no dialogue. Right, where are we going? Who's in Purgatory Bar? Aria. And... Miranda, let's go see what tight suit she's bought.
Now arriving at docking bay D20.
Kinda gutted we didn't get Ashley.
Four.
Present. Skidder! No, wait, we've already done that joke.
Shepard, there you are.
Tight suit confirmed.
Commander Shepard, it's been far too long. We live in interesting times.
A little too interesting.
I couldn't get anywhere near you when the Alliance had you locked up.
Relieved of duty. It was complicated.
I'm sure it was. I'm surprised they didn't court-martial you. The Alliance isn't known for its flexibility.
Doesn't matter now.
Shepard, about Earth.
I'm all right. We'll figure out some way to even the odds. We have to.
Everybody has a weakness. Even the Reapers. I'm sorry, Shepard.
What about you? What brings you here?
I need to talk to a few people. Like you. The Citadel is a good place to meet. For now. What's the Alliance's next move?
We have a plan. It's a long shot.
Not surprising. Shepard? There's something I wanted to mention.
What is it?
I haven't heard from my sister, Oriana, for a while. I'm getting worried.
Your sister?
Yes. I don't want to overreact, but... Well, there's a lot going on.
I thought we made sure she was safe.
We did. It's probably nothing, but... I just know my father is involved.
What happened?
I don't know. Everything I had in place to make sure she was safe went dark.
Good luck!
What do you need from me?
I appreciate the offer, Shepard. But you have your hands full. If I need a door or two kicked down, I know just who to call. But for now, I'll be fine.
Okay. I understand.
I have to figure this out.
Sorry, I'm confused. If she's not wanting my help, then why is she here telling me about it?
You will. Why do you think your father was involved in Oriana's disappearance?
I kept careful tabs on my sister. I always knew where she was. For her to just vanish, it could only be him. After I hid her away, I still knew he'd stop at nothing to find her. She's all he has left. I have a hunch what happened, but I'll fill you in when I'm certain.
Let's talk about the elephant in the room.
Have you had any run-ins with the elusive man?
Just once. He said it had been a pleasure to work with me. But he needed to contain the situation.
Contain the situation? Sounds final.
It nearly was. He doesn't take rejection well.
No, he doesn't.
Oh, so you're no longer Cerberus.
It's been a long time. What happened to you?
I've been in hiding. Being on the run from just about everyone isn't as glamorous as it sounds.
I didn't know.
It's all right. I knew there would be repercussions to walking away from Cerberus.
I imagine. You're a dangerous enemy.
I am.
If you're looking for a lead here, anyone associated with Cerberus will be hard to find.
No question. But I'm owed a few favors. Someone here will give me a tip on Ariana.
I've got to get back to it.
And I should get out of sight.
Be careful.
No promises.
Fair enough. So, what was that? It's a reunion?
Welcome, Commander Shepard. Please select a destination.
One moment, please. Let's go see Araya, whatever her name
now
was.
Now arriving at Ward level, Purgatory.
They were refugees. Damn it, it's not like they had much left to start with. Lost their homes, their loved ones.
I know people are complaining. We're doing what we can with what we've got here, but let me finish.
Those Cerberus bastards had us.
Man, this place is massive. James, what are you doing here?
Hey, Commander. Nice to see you down here in the dirt with us grunts.
You don't think I like getting dirty?
Oh, now, come on. I didn't mean anything by it, Commander.
Uh-huh. What'd you mean, then?
See those Marines over there? None of them officers, just soldiers fighting a war.
Yeah?
They've been buying me drinks all night. You know why? Same reason they got all quiet and serious when you walked in.
You don't seem intimidated by me in the least. In fact, you could use a little more deference.
Sure, but I've fought with you. I've seen you in action. Now, don't get me wrong, you're good. Probably one of the best.
Probably.
But I know you're human. Just like me.
But not them?
Nope. Hell, I still remember the day they made you the first human specter. I watched it on the vids, just like all of them. But to them, you're still larger than life.
Maybe I should expect it. There aren't a hell of a lot of people who've done what I have.
And now they get to meet you in the flesh. You should buy them around. It'll impress them.
I like the way you think, Lieutenant.
Compadres! Hey! The commander would like you to have a drink. On him. So here's to us.
Who's like us?
Damn few! And they're all dead. Sorry, Shep. Thought you'd know that one.
Thanks for the warning.
Thanks for the drink.
Shepherd Shuffle.
Thanks for the drink.
You're welcome. Didn't cost me a credit, I don't think. Should have probably gone with that, went with that renegade option. Wait, what is this? Okay. Where are we going? Oh. Of course.
So you admit you and your thugs are here illegally?
Yes, and it only took CSEC 3 weeks to figure it out.
I don't care who you are. You're required to go through processing like all other refugees. Come with me.
I don't think so. Shirk, get me the Asari counselor.
Arya. To what do I owe the pleasure?
I'm being asked to submit to immigration processing.
I see. And now you've been processed. Is there anything else?
Nothing. Thank you.
Anytime.
I think we're done here. Enjoy the show, Shepard?
I guess there's one rule on the Citadel, huh?
I guess so.
I hate this place. So sickeningly uptight.
Then why are you here?
Welcome back, Ragnar.
Cerberus stole Omega from me. The elusive man is now squarely at the top of my shit list. He will pay for every second I've spent in this bureaucratic hellhole.
How did Cerberus defeat you?
Deceit, distraction, and a big fucking army. They lured me away from Omega and ambushed me. I escaped, but Cerberus had already laid siege. By the time I could launch an assault, they were too entrenched.
At least you escaped to fight another day.
And that day is coming. I'll take Omega back, but I'll get to that. You're here because I have a proposition.
I'm listening.
The way I see it, if you don't defeat the Reapers, we're all dead. Won't matter where I'm sitting. It's in my interest to help you.
What are you offering, Arya?
On Omega, I kept the Blood Pack, Blue Suns, and Eclipse in check. Now they're running amok. Nobody wants that. Unite them under my rule, and you'll have a powerful and ruthless force for your war. I've laid the groundwork with all three groups. I just need you to close the deals.
I did indeed, Cadenzara. I did indeed. I missed the dance option? Aww. Having the mercenaries would be invaluable. Although most of them are just gangs. I think facing extinction, we've kind of got to get into bed with people we wouldn't usually get into bed with.
If they'll fight Reapers, I'll take them.
Now that's a bottom line I can respect. Meet with Gnarl, my agent who's dealing with the Blood Pack. The Blue Sun's leader is incognito here on the Citadel. He'll be expecting you. And I already have a deal with Jonas Sedaris, the Eclipse leader. You just have to get your friend, Commander Bailey, to let her out of jail.
You obviously don't know Bailey very well.
Bailey respects you. Lean on him. I think a united force of professional mercs is worth it. Don't you? It's always a pleasure, Shepard. Let me know if you want to talk later.
Stuck. Shepard, shuffle. Is there anyone I'll piss off by lying with her? Probably a lot of people. Don't mock his dancing, it's better than mine. Besides, when you've saved like the universe twice kind of thing, dance out the hell you want to dance.
Welcome, Commander Shepard. Please select the destination.
Ay. Where is this guy? I cannot remember. I think he's in the embassies. You haven't seen me dance? There's a reason for that, Cadenzara.
Now arriving at Presidium Embassy.
Yes, I have spoken to you before. Why do you refuse to help? I fully understand the situation. Of course I read through the names of the dead every day, but... Please! Please, a few more minutes of searching could mean a lifetime of peace for my family.
Someone in your family is MIA?
My son, Bilal. And bureaucratic compassion seems to be in short supply. I am Ambassador Dominic Osoba. My son's squad returned from their mission on Benning without him. I found them drinking, but they won't even look me in the eye. I can offer a bounty for any information. If Balao's alive, we want him home. If he's dead, then we can begin to mourn him.
If I find anything, I'll let you know.
Thank you. Either way, you will set my mind at ease.
This must suck for people.
Good morning. Oh, hello, ma'am.
Ma'am? We've had this discussion, young lady. You're to call me Teresa. Maybe my son didn't have the chance to marry you because of this damn war. But you're still family in my book. Nothing will ever change that.
Of course, Teresa.
I'll come back later during your break if you want. Treat you to lunch. What do you say?
I would love that, Teresa. Thank you.
Your son's dead. John Dunbar. Hello.
Commander Shepard. John Dunbar, Special Tactics and Recon. I've got intel suggesting that high-level Hanar officials may be indoctrinated.
That's a damning accusation. What have you got?
Evidence of an Alliance Black Ops team raiding a Batarian research station. The Batarians were studying Reaper technology.
The Batarians had Reaper technology?
The Alliance raid turned into a massacre, and the humans ended up with nothing. Your people faked a power failure to hide the incident.
The Batarians would have gone to war if they'd found out. But how does this implicate the Hanar?
They maintained discreet gray market trade relationships with the Batarians, and led the Alliance to the station. We suspect those Hanar operatives escaped with Batarian tech. If your reports on the Reapers are accurate, they could already be indoctrinated.
What's your source on all this?
It was an anonymous gift, but I believe it came from a thief named Kasumi Goto. I've been after her for years.
Kasumi? You're hunting a thief?
A master thief. Her intelligence and skill are almost Salarian.
I'm sure she'd appreciate praise from the Spectre who's chasing her down.
I only need her data. I admire her personally. And since she sent me this, I assume her feelings are mutual.
She's not a Salarian, just to confirm.
What do you need me to do?
The Hanar operative is now a diplomat on the Citadel. I don't have a public name, and the Hanar will go to ground if I make a formal inquiry.
So we're hunting.
I'm tracking suspicious transmissions to the Hanar homeworld. I could use your help.
Let me see what I can dig up at the Spectre office.
Thanks, Shepard. And for the record, not everyone doubted your concerns about the Reapers. I just hope we're not too late.
Is that in my face? No.
So, remember when you helped me get KG's Grey Box from Donovan Hawk? The one with information that could start a war?
I thought we destroyed that information to keep you safe.
There were enough clues left for me to piece things together when I got curious. It was big enough to leak it to Bao. If you don't mind me tagging along cloaked, maybe I can help you dig up some dirt on the Hanar.
I'd appreciate it.
Are you there? Wait, is this a Spectre base? This is a Spectre base? Why didn't I know about these things? We have a Spectre base? What? Military pardons for Normandy engineers. Engineers Gabriella Daniels and Ken Donnelly are in custody on the Citadel for working with Cerberus. Daniels and Donnelly surrendered peacefully before the Normandy was turned over to the Alliance, but have maintained that they were motivated purely to help fight the Collectors and Reapers and had no other connection to the terrorist organization. Spectre authorization could offer Daniels and Donnelly full pardons and reinstate them aboard the Normandy. Oh, yes! I remember those two! I remember those two! They were awesome! Instructors at Grissom Academy have requested facilities in the Citadel to train young students who escaped the attack on the school, but who are not yet ready to join the older students in combat. Citadel authorities will find room for the students if a Spectre approves the request. Yes. Wow, why did I not know about this? Quarian Pilgrim Jen Valan Na Nima on the Citadel received a large credit transfer from the fleet. Jen Valan purchased tech, including high-end weapon mounts and kinetic barrier emitters, from several ship service centers on Ilium. Another Quarian Pilgrim, unidentified, was observed searching for a ship traveling close to Perseus Vale. The Pilgrim was later heard saying that his pilgrimage was recalled. Data suggests the Quarian fleet is withdrawing its pilgrims and upgrading ships for combat somewhere near the Perseus Vale. This could be a reaction to the Reaper invasion, but no formal offer or request for assistance has come. Intel suggests the Quarians may instead be preparing for conflict with the Geth. For the same reason you keep missing shinies, and then deny missing shinies? Well, I'm not as bad at missing ladders. I know where ladders are. Welcome to the Spectrum Information Processing Center. This terminal offers secure information access and support for authorization of covert operations or requisitions. It is restricted to operatives currently on active duty with special tactics and reconnaissance. Any operation requiring payment can be executed at the terminal nearby, which supports secure and untraceable financial transactions. And our embassy tracking. Spectre level access codes can bypass privacy settings and track financial data, transit records, and personal communications for all employees in the Hanar embassy. To avoid triggering surveillance countermeasures, embassy files must be accessed on site. Nav points of consoles or access points with relevant information will be tagged on the Spectre's Omni-Tool.
Shepard, I'm checking security reports. Can you track the transfers coming from the Hanar embassy?
On it.
Bao's got a good plan. Hanar are predictable. Anything suspicious in their terminal use should narrow down our list of suspects.
So, you approve of Bao?
Absolutely. He's a good Spectre. The galaxy needs more like him.
And the fact that he's trying to arrest you?
Well, nobody's perfect.
Hello. Non-human medigel upgrade. Increased injuries among non-human patients at Huerta Medical Hospital has led to a need for improved medigel formula. This would reduce fatalities and free up medical resources across the Citadel. Wait, so I just bought buffs for the shooting range? I have a shooting range? Oh my lord, why didn't I find out about this stuff? What is this room called? It's not. Oh wait, maybe this... Oh, this room was locked! Because I wasn't a Spectre. Ah, that makes sense. That's why I didn't know about it. I haven't been up here since I've been made Spectre. There, in your face right now.
Shepard, to what do I owe the pleasure?
Here to talk about you releasing Jonas Sedaris.
Damn, you too? Somebody got the council to order her release. I'm delaying as best I can. What's your stake in this?
It's classified.
That's a fancy way of saying mind your own business. Look, there's no way I'm letting that psychopath out. The woman's unstable and a clear public threat.
What makes you think she's crazy?
She was a ruthless sadist before she got caught. Her imprisonment has cracked a shell off the nut.
Maybe freedom will improve her.
She rages day and night, Shepard, calling for the deaths of all Eclipse enemies. No, freedom will only give her the chance to kill.
Let me see her.
I'd like access to her to judge for myself.
Sure thing. I'm sure you'll agree. Then maybe the Council will listen to you and rescind the order. Go to the CSEC outpost. My assistant will connect to Sedaris' cell from there. Then call me back.
Will do. I didn't miss it. I didn't miss it. What's the time? Are you asleep? No, you're not. You need to go to bed. Be right back, I'm just putting the bird to bed. It should be 2 seconds. We'll be right back. Yeah, I'm back. Thank you very much for waiting. He does not like being covered one bit. He's there hissing away and protesting. Apparently it's good for him. Besides, he should be happy. He's got my Ben and Jerry's towel I got from America. See, look, I've disturbed him now. Look, he was happy. Ay. I know, Cheeky, I'm sorry.
If you have a question, one moment, please.
Sorry, Cheeky.
Now arriving at Presidium Commons.
Ben and Jerry's, I know.
Things weren't great even before he deployed, and if I pretend to be happy over the bits, it's not fair to him or to you. With all the craziness of a war going on, you deserve to be happy.
And I'm not. I have to be honest with him.
Then you need to tell him.
You're gonna break up your husband who's fighting in the war for the survival of the entire universe just to be with your sorry lover?
So, you want us to enlist as soldiers? Isn't there anything else we can do?
The military needs everyone they can get.
None of us knows how to fight.
Mackenzie's a biotic. Dave and Graham go to the pistol range. Oh, and Orion's always buying mods for his shotgun.
The one he's never even fired. I love our friends, but we are not combat material.
I can't sit around watching what's happening to Earth anymore.
So, you want us to enlist as soldiers? Isn't there anything else we can do?
The military needs everyone they can get.
None of us knows how to fight.
Mackenzie's a biotic.
You two could save lives by helping doctors in the refugee camps.
Thanks? Who was that?
The first human specter.
Wow, Commander Shepard?
Yeah, and it's good advice. Let's sign up as med tent volunteers. How's that sound?
Much better than shooting myself in the foot with a rifle.
Yeah, I mean, I'm all for them all trying to help and everything, but I mean, at the same time, it's... Oh, I can get that armor again.
Cultivating serenity is possible even during times of
fish?
Crisis.
No, I'm not getting fish. We all know what happened to the fish last time.
Of course. The welcome to Elkos Combine Arsenal Supplies.
Cerberus armor. No. Aquarium VI with so many exotic species of fish available in today's galactic market, it takes an expert to maintain the ideal aquariums. VI automatically dispenses food, adjusts the temperature, pH, and algae content of the water, and even talks to the fish when you're not around, leaving you free to enjoy your aquatic friends without fear of killing them. Oh! That's expensive, though. It's 25,000 credits. Olivon, hello.
Traveling someplace safer.
Is it you?
I wouldn't go to the settled worlds.
Is that who I think it is from the Mass Effect 2, the criminal? I'm sorry, Cheeky. Good boy.
If we switch from financial VIs to military gear, we'll lose millions.
Who cares about the money? Haven't you heard the news from Palavan?
That's what your army is for. Nothing's going to reach the Citadel.
We need to start manufacturing military tech.
I've seen Palavan burning. Those fires aren't going out anytime soon. If you can help.
Look, Cyrus, you want to sell your shares of Walk, fine. But I'm not selling financial VI.
All fears surviving continues as the Reapers occupy most of Palavan. It appears that Tyrion...
Thinking of going?
...lose their planet, right?
Wow. I'm going around changing everybody's minds. Blasto 6, partners in crime. Yeah. That, I can't even take that seriously.
Quick, hands behind your back. We'll be here in a minute.
What the hell are you talking about?
Crete, Blood Pack's leader. Arya brings him the great Commander Shepard. Crete pledges the gang to her. We're just luring him into the open so we can take him out.
Not the best start to our friendship, Gnarl.
He's coming. put your hands behind your back and try to look like I beat you up or something.
This better be on the up and up.
Quiet!
I had to look even more powerful than Creep thought. Her instructions on boarding Citadel undetected were one thing. Now this... Commander Shepard, want you to know, your head will be hood ornament on my personal shuttle.
Keep your distance, Creep. So, do you agree to Arya's terms?
Most definitely. Arya can use Blood Pack as she sees fit.
Wasn't talking to you, Creed. Grill?
What? You have my word. Now open fire!
Not him! Grill's next in line to take over. Arya's deal is with him.
Yes! Yes. I'm Arya's mole, Shepard. You've scratched my back. Now I'll scratch yours.
Word of advice. Don't double-cross Arya.
I may be ambitious, but I'm not crazy.
Uh-huh. Good work, Gnarl. Thanks for the gun.
Anytime, Shepard. Grill and I will let Arya know the light is green.
I didn't even realize that was the room. I was just coming here to, you know, Chinese. Just ended up assassinating someone. Although I don't like the Blood Pack.
The Council called the invaders Reapers. The same term was used.
I don't think I can do this anymore.
I know what you mean.
I thought our train prepared us for everything.
Yes. Every time that Asari Commander sees me, she just starts screaming.
There's a C-Sec assistant.
This is problematic. We must find a way to stabilize the heating units.
I'm not done exploring, though.
I'm afraid I can't help you.
But your manager said you could give me a refund if I made an appointment.
You're not on my appointment list, and you don't have a receipt. I don't even think we carry that version anymore.
Listen, I don't need a new model, store credits, or anything. I just want my money back.
There's nothing I can do without a sales record of some kind.
I can go get the warranty book from my car.
I'm afraid I can't help you.
But your manager said you could give me a
Is it him?
If I made an appointment.
No, I don't recognize the voice unless I got a different voice actor. But is it him?
I don't even think we carry that version anymore.
Is it him?
Listen, I don't need a new model.
Welcome to Agor Munitions. Thank you for shopping at Agor Munitions.
Welcome to Cypertine Armory. Thank you for shopping at Cypertine Armory.
Ragnar, is it him?
I'm afraid I can't help you.
But your manager said you could give me a refund.
Look, he's not gonna leave. The sooner you refund him, the sooner you go home.
Yeah, you're right. Let's get this over with. Here, I've sent you a full refund.
Really?
Yes.
You mean it?
Of course I do.
A full refund?
Yes, congratulations. The whole 15 credits.
Oh, wow.
Hey, thanks.
All that for 15 credits.
Welcome to the Citadel gift shop.
Welcome to Nosastra Sporting Goods.
Rector armor. Damn, that looks nice.
All licensed huntresses may apply for a professional discount. Thank you for shopping at Nosastra Sporting Goods.
You're bonded with the audience.
No, actually, my husband's a Krogan.
Oh.
Welcome to Casa Fabrication Weaponry.
Inferno armor? A lot of these armors are from... Wait, Edie?
Neither should you.
I'm so sorry. That was thoughtless.
Hello, Shepard.
You look like you're gathering data.
That is a safe assumption.
Anything big and world-shaking? Man's inhumanity to man? Does objective reality exist? That kind of thing?
I was running scenarios in my head to analyze Jeff's behavior. I believe he has a strong affectionate attachment to me, but he has not stated it to anyone yet. Shepard, You have first-hand sexual experience. How do you know when someone is romantically invested?
I don't want to touch that one with a barge pole. But I want to for the LOLs.
They'll usually show signs they can't stop thinking about you. You know, asking you out, giving you presents, maybe playing music.
I lack material wants other than hardware and software upgrades, and my core programming does not assign values to music. Perhaps we could discuss how to provoke Jeff into an emotional commitment.
That's not how to think of it. It's got to be natural. You need chemistry.
I see. There are a number of pharmaceuticals I could inject to simulate the desired emotional state.
No, I mean relax and do something you both like. Something simple. For example, you both like humor.
Correct. I will see if there are comedic entertainment shows being presented on the Citadel. Scanning. Do you think he would like The Man Who Hung Himself? It appears to be about an amorous plastic surgeon.
Edie, the important thing is to have a good time wherever you go. And if you're having fun, he probably will too.
Then the outcome is an unknown quantity, but you are saying I should attempt it anyway.
Nobody ever fell in love without being a little bit brave.
I see. I believe you have improved my chances.
What have I done?
Thank you.
What have I done? Hey, Joker.
Hey, Commander. Check it out. Big news. The Blasto movie is breaking opening week records. There's also a big expose on Quasar tournaments. Tips on how to make your apartment look bigger. And, oh yeah, a big-ass Reaper invasion. These people have no idea.
When big events shake up the galaxy, people cling to what's familiar.
You say that like it's a good thing.
It's better than riots in the streets.
I guess. I just wish there were a middle ground. You know, a little less gardening advice, a little more war prep.
It'll happen. Once there's something people can do to help.
Meanwhile, they ignore the unshackled AI walking around the Presidium.
She run into any trouble?
No, she's my mobility assistance mech. Thanks to Vrolik Syndrome, I'm legally entitled to bring her everywhere. Finally getting some use out of those disability benefits.
I'm sure she appreciates getting out to see the sights.
Ah, she's earned a little shore leave.
Oh, the LOLs. I'm glad I decided to explore. Hello.
Still working?
One call leads to another, and here I was hoping I'd have time to enjoy the view. The last time I saw the Presidium, remember how it was all rubble after Sovereign attacked?
I barely got to see the Presidium before half of it got crushed.
And by the time they repaired it, it was time for the next invasion. Citadel hasn't seen the reality of this war yet. We should stock up on necessities while we can.
Such as?
Ezo, heavy arms, mercenary groups.
We'll get the people. Take a moment for yourself now and then.
I know. But there's always just one more task or meeting. Speaking of which, talk to the Volus, Barlavon. He'll point you to some mercenaries willing to join us.
Bless her. Barlavon. That was Barlavon, wasn't it?
Welcome
Welcome to Elkos Combine Arsenal
Please visit
Supplies.
Any of our Elkos
Have I glitched him? Affiliate branches for any and all personal that was Balavon, wasn't it? I just need to go to C-second, some other stuff.
Socializing with other children.
But what if there's another attack?
We can't spend our lives waiting for that.
We're in the middle of a war, and I'm just supposed to send him away every morning?
We've got to keep Jake in daycare. He should be socializing with other children.
But what if there's another attack?
Listen, do whatever is best for your family. Just do it soon. Things are bad out there.
We will.
And... thank you.
Alright, Cadenzra, see you later. Take care. Space pigeons? They look like chocobo heads. Yes, I hear you ringing your bell. Still protesting.
I've connected with Jonas Sedaris in her cell, Commander. You can speak with her via that console.
Thanks. We'll need some privacy.
Of course. When you're done, you can also contact Commander Bailey from that terminal.
Who's that spying on me now? Ah, I see. Good. Arya's indentured servant has finally come to deliver me to freedom.
I want to talk with you before I secure your release.
Bullshit. You have no choice. And when I get out, heads will roll. Oh, yes. You've killed a lot of my people. Don't think I've forgotten that.
You have to move on.
And I will, once all my enemies are dead. I love holding all the cards. Even in here, you must deal with me. I have all the power.
Is that right?
Yes. Sane, my second-in-command, is a weak-willed toady. If he had balls, he'd leave me to rot and take control himself. But he won't defy me. He knows better. Now get me out of here, Shepard. Tell Bailey to release me.
Bailey, I've seen Sedaris.
So she's crazy, right? It would be ridiculous to let her out.
Yeah, it kind of would be.
She's a menace. Let me try to make this problem go away.
Sounds good. I'll hold the line until I hear from you.
I think she gave me away, though. I think she gave me away. I need to speak to her second in command. Speak to him, and then we're laughing, right? Let's try this dude again. Okay, he's definitely not letting me talk to him. Oh, this is Codex. I want missions. Doctor on the Citadel needs a new Medigel formula created specifically for aliens. Find a new formula and deliver it to her at the Huerta Memorial Hospital. Yeah, I've done that. I think. Arya Talok has requested assistance in the United Mercenary Bands. Speak to Dana Vosk in the city of the refugee camp. Speak to Commander Bailey's assistant at the Presidium Common C-Sec Station and gain the allegiance of the Eclipse Band. Still around? Are you there? Okay. Have my doohickey. My V button. Let's just double check him. That guy there again. Now he's gone. Maybe we're back to Uriah. That's what I've got to do, go back to her and say, yeah, there's got to be another way. So let's go to the Presidium then. Not the Presidium, Purgatory. Why? Thank you.
Now arriving at ward level, Purgatory.
I hate this guard to be assigned. I hate everything.
Well, if you hate everything, don't worry. Soon we're all going to be wiped out.
Do you guys have a chat?
Look who's here. So what's on your mind, Shepard?
How am I supposed to talk Bailey into letting Jonas Sedaris out of prison?
I've already leaned on the council. Bailey is in direct defiance of their order. So talk to him. One Boy Scout to another, chain of command and all that crap. Take him to dinner, talk dirty to him, whatever works.
Are the Blood Pack falling in line?
With Grill in charge, where all systems go. It's his voice, but my words. Couldn't have asked for a better puppet. The Blood Pack have committed 2,000 Vorcha to the cause. They'll make up the bulk of the army.
We'll talk later.
I'm sure.
Okay, maybe I've got to go to him and C-Sec then. I don't really want to get him to... If I can get the second in command in charge, then that would be better, I think. Daytime and everyone's out getting drunk.
Welcome, Commander Shepard. Please select a destination. One moment, please. Now arriving at Presidium Embassy.
Do I have to get her freed? I don't want to.
Let me know when you've had a chance to talk to Sedaris.
Sedaris? Who's Sedaris? Who's Sedaris? Nothing new. Who's Sedaris? Sedaris.
Good morning.
According to the Council, these galaxy-wide attacks are part of a massive and organized invasion plan.
This is new.
Wow, I have some possible hits. Got some strange money transfers.
Balloon's clean. His money transfers are to support his mistress. Not sure about Olun. I'll pull his bio.
I'll check Olun's personal records and pull his recent messages.
Can I just note how odd it is for a Hanar to have a mistress?
You know, if Bao catches up with you, I can grant you immunity.
What, if I join up? Last time I did that, you wrote me into a suicide mission.
I didn't say you had to join up.
You were working your way around to it.
Not at all. Yeah, Hannah having a mistress? Does sound a bit odd, actually. Seriously, if I, I don't know where I'm going.
Welcome, Commander Shepard. Please select a destination. One moment, please. Now arriving at Presidium Commons.
Terminal. Nope, not looking for the terminal. I'm looking for someone named Sidonis. Oh, now I can torture you.
Commander Shepard. It's been some time. Barlavon, in case you've forgotten. Financial advisor. And an acquaintance of Admiral Anderson. I admire the courage it took for him to stay and fight on your home world.
You used to be an agent for the Shadow Broker.
I still am. The Broker has been exceedingly busy lately. A team of his guards have become stranded in a Reaper-controlled territory. Rescue the guards, and they're yours. The Shadow Broker fully supports your efforts against the Reapers.
Are you passing on the location of these mercs for free?
Their leader's offering a handsome commission for their rescue. Everyone wins, Commander. Come see me once you've completed the extraction. I'll be in my office a while longer. The galactic market is in considerable flux.
The Shadow Broker's on my side, you say? I'm sleeping with the Shadow Broker.
Have you decided how to tell him?
I don't know, but Ted's message is so impersonal.
You don't think Sanctuary is
real? Man, you look horrible.
I don't know what it is I'm doing. For this Blue Sun mission. Ah, he's back. Got no dialogue with him.
He's under attack. All the Asari colony is across the galaxy from Palavin and Earth.
Well, I'm going down. I don't want to be going down. What have we got? We got bank apartments, Apollo's Calf, Courtyard C-Sec, Meridian Place Market. Over there. Animals above.
The council called the invaders Reapers. The same term once used by a disgraced commander.
No sense. How the hell do I get up over there? There's nothing over there. Unless that's a bug from whatever. I'm getting confused.
Welcome, Commander Shepard. One moment, please. Now arriving at...
Yeah, that's a bug. Marvin.
I found this metagel formula and figured you could make good use of it.
Where did you find this? Never mind, it doesn't matter. Yes, we can put this to good use. Thank you. No, it's fine. We won't be needing your supplies after all.
No, it's completely tasteless to call this place Huerta Memorial.
President Huerta,
I meant to say the man was dead for an hour and a half and his political enemies piled on enough propaganda to get the hospital name changed.
Having a VI drive your body isn't life. Are Reaper husks alive?
You did not just say that.
But it's the same thing, isn't it? He walks and makes noises just like they do.
Fine. I guess I'm just surrounded by zombies.
Thanks. Took her long enough to get the hint.
You're welcome. Ooh.
He got out of that farm and into the hills. He pulled the farm girl after me. All I wanted to do was live through the night.
Nobody else could have done more.
But morning came and no shuttle. Afternoon and then night, and I'm hiding from husks and those Turian things.
The file says the evacuation team thought your position was overrun.
So after 2 days, I still don't have a gun, because those Turian things, you can't use theirs. I realize that shuttle isn't coming, not unless I get back to the farm and my radio.
And the farm girl?
She was with me. Even killed a few husks. With a stick.
Stick, fair play, Will. I don't know where this Sardonis guy is.
Please select a destination.
Rings a bell, but sod it, let's look it up.
Areas tagged of interest to you are highlighted on the elevator menu. If you have a question, one moment, please.
Down here.
Now arriving at docking bay E24.
Spell. Alun's doing some heavy lobbying for the Hanar to support the war effort.
So he's clearly not indoctrinated. Who's opposing him?
It all comes down to the war, and you trying to pull everyone into it.
You can't.
Would you rather the Reapers win?
Yes, no. And I owe you for getting KG's gray box back from Hawk. But I can't do another collector base, Shep. The Reapers aren't people. I can't infiltrate a Reaper party and steal a big I win bomb.
Excuse me, what was your name again?
Dekar.
Christoph Wasser. Good to meet you. How long have you been here?
I don't know. I'm not in there.
I don't know how long it was since I escaped Lyon. Do you know Lyon?
No.
The
Alliance military has abandoned. Oh, this is a refugee camp.
Yes, we can. Tell your friends to move their ship out of the docking bay.
Wait, please. My family's on board. Just let them land. I'll pay.
This isn't about money. The wards are already at capacity for refugees. There's just no room.
You let Asari in here earlier.
That's back when we had space.
Where is my family supposed to go?
I don't know, all right. But they can't land here.
You can't turn people away.
Sure you can't squeeze in a few more people, officer?
And who the heck are you? Oh, Commander Shepard. If that's what you think, I'll find them some room.
So my family can dock?
Commander Shepard says your family's cleared. Just tell them to hurry.
Thank you, Commander. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. That's probably a bad thing, but... gotta do our best for everyone, haven't we? Anyway, I'm afraid it is now bedtime. So, yeah, we've just hit the 3-hour mark. As much as I want to continue with that, I'm afraid I am having to go to bed as I have work in the morning. But we will be resuming more Mass Effect 3 next Monday at 8 p.m. BST, British Summer Time. As usual, of course, being new to the game, absolutely no spoilers. However, one thing I will be looking at doing when I get paid is buying the DLC. I believe there's 3 DLCs that are worth getting. So I'll be getting those just to add to the storyline. We'll try and make sure we do as much as we possibly can before the final battle. But as we've only just not long started, we've got a lot to do. But it's fun and I'm looking forward to it. Now tomorrow, with it being Tuesday, means another Skyrim playthrough. I've got to write the diary for that, those of you that aren't aware. I keep a diary of our character, we're sort of role-playing it. At the start of each stream we read out the diary of all the things we did the previous week. So I'll be writing that up and getting ready for that tomorrow. And that starts at 8 p.m. BST. But as I say, it's good night from me now. Thank you very much for hanging out with me, guys. It has been a lot of fun. And I will see you soon. Do enjoy the week, as we were on Monday, so we've got plenty of it to go. And I will see you later. Take care, everybody, and good night.